Welcome everybody. Today's video, what we're going to do is we're going to go and we're going to see the top 10 temples here in Siem Reap. I'm going to show you a little bit about them and tell you a little bit about it so you can see what to expect when you come here. And where we're starting out is right here. We're at the Angkor Enterprises, which is where you got to buy your ticket for getting into the park. So let's look here right quick and then we'll go see all the temples. The ticket booth, and there's tuk-tuks, and this is where all the buses come. Now you have to come here yourself because they put your picture on the ticket, and whenever you go to all the temples they compare. And then over there is a museum, so you can rent a bike and you can pedal it around, you can go to the tuk-tuks, you can hire out the little vans, whatever you want. Have a little coffee shop, and then over here is the ticket windows. Now you're gonna need at least a three-day pass to go and see all of this. A three-day pass is $62 and a seven-day pass is $72. It looks like a one-day pass is $37. And they have a little gift shop here, but you'll see plenty of those when you're around at all the temples. This temple is located about 40 kilometers east of the main temples in Angkor. The name means Temple of the Lotus Pond. It's surrounded by a humongous moat that is 1.2 kilometers by 900 meters. The temple itself is built and it's believed to have been the prototype model for Angkor Wat. The layout is built in a similar fashion. The stone carvings are not as intricate as Angkor. What makes this temple unique is its natural setting. You can explore the temple by a bridge that's elevated up above the temple, and you can see the trees and the nature, how it's intertwined into the bricks. A lot of the walls have collapsed down, but it gives you a unique look at what the temple is and how it was built. It's away from the crowds and a little bit difficult to get to, but well worth the stop. This is one of the most distinctive temples built by the Khmer Empire in the Siem Reap area. It was originally a Hindu temple constructed in 961 or 962. The outer wall measures 117 by 127 meters in length and has a humongous Gopura entrance on each of the four sides, as along with the inner wall. The inner and outer wall align with the four cardinal directions on a compass. The outer enclosure once contained halls which have been eroded over the last 1,000 years. The most striking part of this temple is the inner enclosure. It features a pyramid structure with a base of 50 meters wide. The pyramid rises 12 meters in three tiers. The top levels of the tier have a large platform with the five towers. The center one represents Mount Meru. This temple is located about 25 kilometers northeast of the main groups of temples in Angkor. It's a 10th century Hindu temple that was dedicated originally to Shiva. Most of the buildings that you see are made out of red sandstone. The sandstone was easily carved. The buildings themselves are smaller than what you normally find. Most people, whenever they see this temple, they think of it as a precious gem or jewel of Khmer art. It was originally consecrated on the 22nd of April in 967. It's the only major temple in Angkor that was not built by one of the kings, but were built by some of the priests. Thank you. This temple was built at the end of the 9th century, more than 200 years before Angkor Wat was built. This used to be the principal temple in the area. It's located on top of the hill, making it the most popular temple in Siem Reap to catch the sunsets. It's built to honor and represent Mount Meru, the home of the Hindu gods. That's why it was built on top of a hill. It is structured in a pyramid form of seven layers, each symbolizing one of the seven heavens. From the upper terrace of the temple, you get an incredible view of the area, the dense jungle, and Angkor Wat in the distance. Bayon, which means coiled serpents, is one of the most unconventional temples that you will find in the Angkor area. It's built on an island in the middle of the northern Barray. It was originally built in the second half of the 12th century by King Jayavarman VII. The main pond was attributed curative powers by the Angkor inhabitants and was possibly used as pilgrimage places where people could come and bathe in order to be healed physically and mentally. One of the theories maintains that the pond may be a replica of Lake Annavatapadrata in the Himalayas, which is a mythical lake at the top of the universe that is a source of the four great rivers of the earth. Takia was one of the tallest monuments in the Angkor area. It was built in the 11th century and it represents Mount Meru. The shape of the temple is a 22 meter high, five layer pyramid with five sanctuaries on the top level. The building project was abandoned before the temple was finished, so the monument lacks any real detailed stonework. Legend has it that it was struck by lightning and it interrupted the construction because that was deemed a bad omen. It has some very nice views of the area, but not as nice of views as Phnom Baking. It was built in the middle of the 12th century to the beginning of the 13th century. This is one of the hidden gems in the Angkor area. Its name translates to Citadel of Chambers, which explains kind of the maze of corridors that you get yourself into when you're exploring this temple. This is a medium-sized temple with the layout consists of three enclosures with an outer compound wall. There are some very nice stone carvings on the inner walls. This temple, though, was built with an inferior grade of sandstone, and it had a lot of deterioration, but has had some extensive restoration. This is a temple that is away from the crowds, so if you want to come here for some photo ops, this is definitely someplace you need to stop. This is one of the most popular temples to visit in the Angkor area. Recently, it's gained some popularity from the film Tomb Raider with Angelina Jolie. This temple was built in the 12th century as a Buddhist monastery and a center for learning. It follows the typical Khmer structure with a sanctuary centered around the enormous smiling face of Prajnaparamita. The temple was abandoned in the 15th century after the fall of the Khmer Empire. The jungle took over the temple, giving it its unique look. When Siem Reap was rediscovered in the 20th century, an effort of restoration began, but it was decided that it was best to leave this in its state that it's in right now, making it one of the most recognizable temples in the world. This is the last state temple that was constructed in the Angkor area by the late Khmer King Jaravarman VII. Construction of the temple began near the end of his life, somewhere in the late 12th or early 13th century. It was originally intended to be a Buddhist temple. It was later altered to become a Hindu temple by King Jaravarman VIII in the mid 13th century. It again was later altered to become a Buddhist temple again under subsequent rulers. The most distinctive feature of this temple is by far the smiling faces. Some believe it is the Buddha, some believe that it is the late king. But whenever you're exploring it, you're always within sight of a few of the smiling faces. There's also some very nice stone carvings along the inner courtyard that you want to take a look at. This is a must-see, definitely one of the top three temples in Angkor. Angkor Wat was built in the 12th century. The monument was initially devoted to the Hindu god Vishnu, but it was later transformed into a Buddhist temple. Angkor Wat is the pinnacle of Khmer architecture. The temple is designed as a miniature replica of the universe. The central tower symbolizes the mythical mountain Mount Meru. The five surrounding towers correspond to the peaks surrounding Mount Meru. The outer temple wall symbolizes the edge of the world mountains, while the moat represents the oceans beyond. Out of all the temples in Siem Reap, this is undoubtedly the most photographed and most famous one. This is a must-see for anyone stopping. That's going to finish up our video over here in Siem Reap. That's the top 10 temples that, in my mind, that you got to see when you're here. There's tons of others, so don't think that those are the only ones that you have to see. And you may have your own favorite or some that you think are, you know, can't miss. And if you know a few others, leave them in a comment. Tell me what you think, or tell me which one is your favorite. Yeah, where I'm at right now, I'm back at the hotel. I'm at the Cheetah Residence. This is a nice place. The people are really friendly. I stayed here for a week and I would stay here again. The people are really, really great. I had a problem with my motorcycle. They helped me get it all fixed up and they went above and beyond. So I'll put their contact information into the video. And if you like the video, smash the like, subscribe if you're new here, stick around. I show you things that I see, tell you a little bit about what I know. So if you like that, then you found the right place. And if you're subscribed, you're notified when I post a new video. And leave me a comment, tell me which one is your favorite, And until next time, from over here in Siem Reap, remember, life is a journey. Enjoy.